Well, it's good to stand here. It's nice to have all your attention. Thank you. I was just thinking, what will I say? So the thing just came up, some personal experience. Like I started Aikido quite some time ago, and in 2004, my teacher invited Maruyama Sensei to Holland. And coincidence made it happen that he stayed at my house. So I had no idea, I just said yes, it felt good, and I didn't know what it will bring. It was really a great gift.
2004年、マルチ先生が、マルチの家に泊まられたそうです。それが最初のきっかけで、非常に今から考えると運命の出会いみたいな感じだったんです。
I directly felt a personal connection, and from the first time I met Sensei, then I knew I'm going to follow him, and I want to follow Aikido Yushinkai to be really connected to what Sensei is doing. He's very honest about following the way of Aikido, and he's really he's taught by O-Sensei, and this was for me the best opportunity I ever had in my life, so I just totally went for it from there. When I was younger, I did like other martial arts, like really like here they call it probably K1, like Thai boxing, kickboxing, and pentaxilot. So I was kind of more in the fighting mode. But later, when I was in my early 20s, I got some experience that I am universe itself. So my whole perception on life changed. And then also Aikido came on my path. So I started doing Aikido. And that's really my life mission, to help people to become connected to the self, to the key that's in yourself, to connect it to the other, and to connect it to the space around you, to the universe. This is not just words, but it's why I'm here alive, why I'm here as a human being, to help myself and others to grow in that direction.
最初若い頃に、K1 とか言ってたんですよ。若い頃と私20代想像してたんで、その後20代で広げてあって、やっぱり意識が変わったんですね。で、本当にこれからその本当の武道、その戦いのものではなく、自分が宇宙と一体となる道ではある。
Okay, so then I started following Maruyama Sensei, and I was really happy because in Europe we got taught through also some Japanese teacher, but I knew my technique was not so good, so I went to Japan and I learned a lot from Sensei since then to polish my techniques. He also sent me to Okajima Sensei to help me even polish more. So that helped me, my technique and also my spirit, to always stay open, keep the open mind and listen to what's there. Even if I heard it 10 times, I'm still listening like it's the first time and try to take in what he's saying. So yeah, during the years I came here, I think about 10 times, I got to meet many of you, we got some kind of friendship, we know each other, and it's growing. So I think that's also an important part of Aikido, that we get to know people from other countries, just enjoy doing Aikido together. Also learning, but being dedicated and focused that you do the right learning, the right practice. And we're not about fighting and throwing each other, but really, and I truly resonate with what you're saying, like we are purifying ourselves. And that's really the only reason why I'm doing Aikido. I don't need to fight. When there's a fight, the universe decides anyway. So, but I want to purify myself for daily life, that I have a good relationship with myself and others. And that's really what I think what it's all about.
同じ言葉とか同じメッセージを聞いても毎回違うんですね。それから心を本当に開いたままにすると
新鮮なその深いところまでその意味が分かります。でそれを、まあ、要するに繰り返しによって、ちゃんと身につきますし、それから、皆さんといろんな、世界の国に、まあ、友情関係ができて同じ道に歩んでいるのは非常に嬉しいことです。あ、それからあの汚れ、今日のメッセージは戦うんじゃなくて汚れを、まあ、落とすとか、それから再生でした、ね、義士再生 の、 あの気持ちがあの今日非常に感銘を受けました。
Well, thank you very much. So, I'm just very happy to have met you. Sometimes we say like, you're my father. They were at the seminar. I said, oh, this is my son. And then the people looking like, oh, really?
親子のような関係ですけども、みんな見てあれですけど。
But now we became brothers. So that's really good.
兄弟。
So I'm really happy, and I really want to help to carry the legacy from O Sensei, from you, and as long as I live to dedicate myself to keep on spreading Aikido Yushinkai and Aikido, the true Aikido. And I hope you all join me, and basically I recognize the key in all of you, like the true essence that we are, and I greet you and I respect you, and I love to be in contact, so let's enjoy what's there. Thank you very much.
ジャパニーズは。
ああ、わかりません。上手じゃありません。すみません。
まあ、いいお言葉を頂戴して、本当に感激です。今ね、ここで皆さんにご報告しなきゃいけないの。日本の方はご存知の方いると思います。三国志っていう小説知ってますか？知ってます。あれ劉備玄徳っていうね、漢の王朝の、ね、劉備玄徳っていう漢の王朝の正当な推定だったんですけど、乱れちゃって蜀と魏と呉と3つの国に中国が分かれたんですよ、ね、その蜀にその劉備玄徳がいたわけですね。そこでその劉備玄徳が昔の漢のね、それに戻したい漢の国、その頃入ってきたのが漢字なんですよ。だから漢に戻したいということで、まあ兵を挙げたわけです ね。そこでその劉備玄徳のところに長谷さんに来たのが漢武と張飛という二人の、それで、まあ、その公園の誓い、桃の園とね、そこで3人で義兄弟の誓いを挙げたんです。この誓いっていうのは、死ぬまであなたを裏切りませんよ、我々3人がね、共に命をかけて、命をかけて、ね、昔の漢の時代に戻しましょうと。それが桃園の誓い。その桃園の誓いを今ここで彼と私とやったわけです。つまり本当の正当な合気道に戻す、ね、それで漢武将軍っていうのは、ね、漢武の大刀、大きな刀ですって有名なんです。もう20キロぐらいある刀を、ね、振り回したんです。彼35キロの、ね、ケトルベルを片手でブンブン振り回すんです。150キロのバーベルをね、ベンチプレスでポンポカポンポカ、ね、何十回も上げるんです。だからまさに漢武将軍なんです。今横浜の中国中華街に行くと漢武将軍、漢武廟ってありますよ、ね、漢武将軍が生き返ってここに戻ってきたよ。張飛はこちら、こんなね勇猛なことにかけてはね、後で聞けない、貴様非常に勇気のある。だからその漢武と張飛がその劉備玄徳助けて、それで三国志の話が始まったんです。ということで今その桃園の誓いをここでやりましたので、ね、この3人は義兄弟となりましたので、おお。
So the Tōen Tōen no Chikai is was a vow taken by three generals during the period of the civil wars in China when
the kingdom was split into three warring states. And they came together, I can't remember all the names of the individuals, but they came together and created a vow of friendship that they would maintain this for the rest, and they would never never go against or never stab anyone in the back. There would be the three vows that they would take. And he described Peter as resembling one of these, a man who was incredibly strong. Get on. Are we okay? And then also Martin resembling another one who was a great Chogi, having great courage in the face of difficulty. And just a few minutes ago, and I got a photograph of it, which I will send to you, and you can share with others. Sensei and Peter and Martin took this vow, joining hands, that they would, for their entire life, work together as brothers in this mission.